人は、食べることで、生きていけると思うんですけど、と同時に、美意識を高めるっていうことも、生きていく上では欠かせないものだと思って。
Hi guys, welcome to another video. I am joined today by Mihao. So, torrential downpour recently has flooded the Kamigawa.
And not every heavy rain indicates a climate change, but it does make you think about it, how it changes every year.
And when we think about climate change, we want to think about how we can become more sustainable, and food and sustainability is a very important topic.
And recently, we had a lot of new restaurants popping up in Kyoto that do have the sustainability in mind. And one of those restaurants is a vegan ramen restaurant, which combines sustainability and art and blends them really well together.
And that is what we are going to check out today, so come with us. Entering Uzu, you are greeted by a very straightforward design language. Narrow hallway into the main dining room. And in the dining room, there is a large marble table around which everyone will sit. Mihao and I opted to sit as close as we possibly could to the mural because it's cool, it's artistic, and good lighting while we're trying to film in a very dark space.There is a minimal aesthetic to everything, that's the utensils, and as well, the menu. There are not a ton of items that you order, but I believe what that accomplishes is that there's not so many ingredients for the chef to keep track of, that everything that comes out of the kitchen is going to be its absolute top quality, and nothing suffers for having so many different options to prepare.
じゃあお願いします。
はい。醤油ラーメン。
はい。
I'll have the other one you were going to have.
Spicy miso?
Yeah, let's try that.
Yeah.
お願いします。
Miso 1と醤油1で。
はい。お願いいたします。
So, this will be my first ramen in my entire life. Not first vegan or vegetarian ramen. First ramen overall. I've been living in Japan for more than a decade now, but I was born in a vegan family.And never had ramen, so I'm really, really excited to dig into it. And this tomato on top looks really tempting, but the staff told us that we should hold off. Get like 3 or 4 bites of the soup and the noodles, and then go for the tomato, the roasted tomato, because it will just change the experience of the whole soup and the dish itself. So, yeah. I'm getting chills just thinking that after 10 years in Japan, I'm gonna have my first ramen.
The art which you find in Uzu is not art for art's sake. The owner, when we got a chance to sit down with us, told us that he collaborated with Team Labs, a very famous art installation group out of Tokyo, to make sure that there was a connection between the art and the food that was served.
Team Labs のアートは、デジタルなので、物質じゃないんですね。データなので、とてもサステナブルで、僕はビーガンと相性がいいと思って一緒にやろうっていうことを声をかけました。
So the oshizushi here is totally for vegan and it's made from edamame paste mixed with wasabi. It has some lotus root, spinach, shiso, and the sushi rice is made.With red vinegar, and the recipe for that very special traditional red vinegar has been passed down through generations. All right, vegan oshizushi. Let's see how it goes. いただきます。 This is gorgeous. Like, it has so many layers. You get the rice with the red vinegar.In the background, that flavor stays in the background all the time. And then you get this punch of wasabi, and then a bit of mushrooms, and like all those different layers of flavors that just come one after another. It's brilliant. Wow.
My culinary weapon of choice was the spicy miso ramen, and I was not disappointed. I've often had miso, but never the spicy style, and that extra kick, that bit of heat,made it nearly divine, and definitely the star of the show was that huge chunk of delicious aromatic onion.
So now I'm ready to level up my first ramen experience by digging in this tomato and making it part of the soup. Yeah, oh, a nice chunk of tomato in my noodles. Wow, that's gonna be amazing. nice. You get this extra kind of roasted tomato. It's not bitter, but not sweet either. It's just in the middle. And the acidity of tomato making the soup much more fresh and light. It's... You have to try this, guys. I said it already like 5 times today, but you do have to try it. Well done.
Unplanned and all the more special for that reason, the owner agreed to come out and have a conversation with us about his concept, where he had come from, and why he had created the experience that you find at Uzu.
Vegan Ramen Uzu Kyoto の owner の片岡です。はじめまして。店のオープンは去年の3月16日、もうまさにコロナと一緒にオープンした感じなんですが、頑張ってます。でこの店はなぜ作ったかというと、もともと僕は、普通のラーメンを、23年ぐらい前からいろいろ作ってました。である時、より未来に向けたこうサスティナブルな、食を提供したいと思って考えていったところ、ビーガン専門でラーメンをやろうっていうことになりました。で、なぜこういうアートな空間と一緒にしたかっていうと、人は、食べることで、生きていけると思うんですけど、と同時に、美意識を高めるっていうことも、生きていく上では欠かせないものだと思って、その2つを一度に体験できる、吸収できる、場所を作ったら、よりお客様が喜んでくれるんじゃないかと思って、チームラボと一緒に、デザインじゃなくてアートっていう領域で、飲食店を考えようっていう、取り組みです。
When Mihao and I went into the restaurant today, I immediately commented that this looks like a place that is really loved by whoever created it.
We haven't pre-arranged the interview with the owner, but he was working in the kitchen and agreed to meet us after our meal.
Which confirmed at that point, we really do think he cares. He loves the place. He's involved in every part of the process, from the food to the design, everything.
Not everyone can open a sustainable restaurant, but what you can dois choose where you eat tomorrow.
So that's what we want to encourage you to do. Whatever in your local neighborhood may have popped up that has sustainability in mind, we encourage you to check it out, and maybe you can have an experience as wonderful as we had at Uzu Ramen. That's all for today's video, guys. Thanks very much for watching. We really, really appreciate it. Please do like, subscribe, hit that bell notification if you should so choose, and leave a comment down below. We'll catch you in the next video. Peace. Thank you.